At Zebu Safaris, we exist to provide you with the most ultimate African safari and culture experience second to none. Backed by details and every bit of knowledge, we guarantee a combination of exceptional services with personal and professional attention from professional and experienced personnel. We are more than just a tour company. We are a brand new experience. Zebu Safaris, true touch, splendid moments. Your number one East African tour partner.
Claimed it as the Pearl of Africa in his book, My African Journey. The gateway into the country is Entebbe Town. When one is coming in from the skies to land at Entebbe Town, one is given a teaser of what to expect on this beautiful country.
African heritage. Moving more northeastwards, one encounters the Karamajong people whose passion for cattle is very intense. They live in manyatas, a collection of huts in an enclosure.
In this region, recent paleontological excavations have revealed very early evidence of mankind.
The visitor will also come across the Chidepo Valley National Park, a semi-desert savanna with a wide range of rare animal species. It is one of the many national parks in the country. Another high-altitude mountain, the Moroto, is found here. It is a favorite destination for mountain climbers. The Karamajong excursion is a rare tourist journey where one is often alone to ponder and wonder at Mother Nature in her most native form. The western part of Uganda is one beautiful wonderland. There are golden grasslands. They are grazed by the graceful Ankole cattle. Green tea essence in temperate climates. A journey to the west is an enchanting trip in flora and fauna. There are game parks, game reserves, and forest reserves in this region. 2.5 hours away from Kampala, one begins to see the wild animals. Lake Mburu National Park is home to the zebra, that beautiful horse-like animal, so tasty to the lion. There are also numerous antelopes and bucks. Going more southwestwards, one will end up in the Mgahinga Mountain Gorilla National Park. And here you will climb the Mgahinga Mountain Ranges, which will be a delightful physical exercise and a walk through varieties of beautiful plants growing in a very cool environment. But the biggest trophy here is the mountain gorilla. Many visitors here come to track the rare mountain gorilla, which is found only in this part of the world. Veering northwestwards is windy, impenetrable rainforest, another habitat of a few remaining mountain gorillas. It is a totally different experience here.
President of Uganda, Yoweri Museveni, led a visual expedition of the CNN into this area to showcase the world's few remaining mountain gorillas, among other things. This placed the world's attention on the windy, impenetrable rainforest and exposed another side of Uganda to the rest of the world. Gorilla trackers have called this a very unforgettable experience.
In southwestern Uganda, we come to Lake Bunyonyi, Uganda's deepest lake. A boat ride on the lake is an unforgettable experience. A picturesque and colorful sight of terraced Chigezi Hills give the visitor a sense of living of a lifetime dream of encountering a perfect terrestrial beauty. Bird watching on the shores of the lake is a bonus for the visitor. Going on more northern, one passes through villages choreographed with banana plantations and long-horned cattle. Within this backdrop are beautiful crater lakes, a result of early earth movements and volcanic activity. One can take a boat ride or sit by the banks of one of these lakes, which will bring forth an immediate sublime feeling. One other water mass here is the Lake Katwe, a salt excavation site that dates back thousands of years.
It is evidence of a great salt industry and trade that stretched all over the entire Interlacustrine region. Further downfield, one comes across Lake George and Lake Edward, two azure light peaceful waters separated by the Kazinga Channel. Here one can go fishing on a canoe, which is the main occupation of the people who live around the lakes. It is at the edge of these waters that one enters Uganda's second biggest national park, the Queen Elizabeth National Park. Once inside the park, the huge array of animal species will parade before you in their natural castes, some stopping to stare at the intruder with curiosity. The Queen Elizabeth is a majestic expression of the meaning of the word safari, that Swahili word now adapted by the English language to mean travel. At Mweya Safari Lodge, you will rest and eat like a royal as the beauty of Africa unfolds in front of you. Going on more and westward, you'll cross the equator once again and face the Rwenzori mountain ranges. When the early explorers were told of a mountain with snow at the top, they put it down to native nonsense, but history has absolved them. Thousands of mountain climbers have made their way to the Margarita Peak, where it is always snow, as in the polar regions of the world. Making one's way to the top is a feat in itself. Going through a breathtaking hazardous terrain of numerous ecosystems, which goes through the dense montane forest to the snow-covered peaks. Along the trail, one will see unique vegetations, glacier river primates, and wonder features such as gorges. It is like a summary of the earth here, and this is what has attracted famous people to the Rwenzoris. One of them, the Italian Duke of Abruzzi, took photographs in 1906 and wrote a book that was to make the Rwenzoris world famous.
But the Rwenzoris did not have to be announced to be famous, because it is the third tallest mountain in Africa.
At its foothills is a vast expanse of natural rainforest, complete with chimpanzees, monkeys and baboons. There are also many varieties of birds. It is a good destination for bird watching, chimpanzee tracking and community walks. Still in the west, one can go on to reach the Semliki River, a meandering wonder. And then there are the Sempaya Hot Springs, a 2 acre of bubbling steam from underneath the earth. People come here from near and far to bathe in the healing steam of the hot springs. Seven miles from here live the Batwa, a 3 feet tall people whose habitat is the dense tropical forest. They are a subject of great interest to anthropologists, conservationists, and human rights organizations because their pre-industrial way of life is being besieged by modernity. The West is also the mother of Uganda's kingdom culture.
One time these kingdoms were one large empire known as Kitara, which split into 5 kingdoms, modern Uganda.
Bunyoro, Buganda, Busoga, Toro, and Ankole. The earlier 4 are active, while the last one is in abeyance. It was at the courts of these monarchs that the politicking that was to make modern Uganda took place. Here, people like Speke, Stanley, Lugard met the Kabaka of Uganda to persuade him to accept the overlordship of the British Empire, while Emine Pasha and Sir Samuel Baker tried unsuccessfully to wrest power from the Omukama of Nyoro. There are important monuments left in their wake to remind of the history of that time.
Two particularly dominant figures of the time, Mutesa and Kabalega, are found in all history books written about Uganda in the 19th century.
The former for inviting the white man into the country and the latter for fighting him. Their tombs are now important tourist attractions and destinations in Uganda.
Kabalega is interned at Mparo, while Kasubi tombs, where Mutesa was buried, is listed among the UNESCO's World Heritage Sites. Uganda's heritage does not only lie in architectural relics and regalia of former monarchs. It is to be found in nature as well.
In the heart of Uganda's central region at Mubende Hill, one finds a tree of vintage presence that is linked to an influential priestess known as Nakaima, who is presumed to have lived around the 16th century.
The tree itself dates back to earlier times. It is believed to be the oldest tree in Uganda.
This tree still serves as a spiritual shrine to the famed priestess and is much visited by both local and foreign tourists. A great many natural sites have been preserved, like the Nakaima tree, such as the rocks which serve as a spiritual destination for many believers. There are many such interesting rock formations throughout the country, with the mysterious caves to accompany them. On the rocks and trees you add the waterfalls, a myriad of them in maritime Uganda. Take the Seziwa Falls, 45 minutes drive from Kampala.
Then there's the Sipi Falls in the eastern part of the country, famous for its attractiveness in addition to ancient myths about it. It is endowed with temperate weather that gives the traveler a good feeling while resting in the green gardens overlooking the falls.
At Bigobia Mugenyi in southern central Uganda, the excavated remains of the powerful Chwezi dynasty, believed to have come from the Ethiopian highlands, are found.
Here, excavators found iron implements, pottery, and other artifacts of great anthropological value.
The recent history of the impact of Arabs and Europeans.
These visitors, who first traded in slaves, guns, and trinkets, left more of an enduring mark on the land and the people of East Africa. They also brought with them different religions.
The Arabs brought Islam as a new way of worship. While the Europeans brought Christianity, Uganda today is the realm of the two religions.
At Namugongo, there are Muslim, Protestant, and Catholic shrines to commemorate the famous Uganda martyrs.
These people were martyred by Mwanga, a Buganda monarch, who was against the foreign influence on his subjects as brought along by the new religions. He ordered them to denounce their faith at the pain of death.
They met their death with great spirit and enthusiasm and have since been beatified by the Roman Catholic Church and honored by Uganda, which has set aside a national day in their memory.
Pilgrims from all over the world converge at Namugongo to hold Holy Mass in memory of these martyrs. A martyr's trail has been established, tracing their journey to Namugongo, where they met their death. It brings glimpses of spiritual Uganda to the travelers. Traveling down the Nile, one encounters the Karuma Falls, where the river's momentum is much more furious as it hits the rocks that separate northern Uganda from the south. Amazing to see, but this is nothing to compare with the experience of the Makshon Falls, whose picture is backdropped with a vast national park, another of the country's game wonders. The Makshon Falls are in the middle of the Makshon Falls National Park. A ride downstream the waterfalls is a breathtaking experience. A real parade of the crocodiles, elephants, buffaloes along the banks of the river, welcoming the visitor to their habitat with a lot of curiosity. Here also marks an ethnic separation.
The people of the north are Nilotics, who migrated from Sudan and southern Egypt.
Legend talks about their warlike traditions, which were greatly exploited by General Gordon, Emin Pasha, and Sir Samuel Baker in their effort to colonize sub-Saharan Africa for the Egyptian Khedives, who ruled between 1820